I mean, I just really like Phillip Lindsay. I like what the Broncos have going on. They had a banged up offensive line last year. They're going to get Ron Leary back from the torn Achilles. They signed Juwan James. They drafted Dalton Risner in the second round. PFF has him sitting at 12th overall coming in at 19. I like Phillip as a player. I mean, he's crafty. He's super fast. He's a knife runner is what I want to call him, a knife runner. He's knifing through defenses.
He does do that.
He's got all the tools.
He's really good. He's fun to watch.
You can press the line of scrimmage. He's got speed to get to the corner. His legs move so fast, he looks like the Roadrunner out there. But then right. He's also got a little Bugs Bunny in him where it's like, you know that scene where like everyone jumps into the pile and it's just like a scruff of dust and you can't see the guy anymore, and then all of a sudden Bugs Bunny's chilling on the other side like unscathed. Like, yeah. That's Phillip Lindsay getting through trash with good contact balance and just a slithery ability. And, you know, the change of direction, he looks twitchy out there.
Right.
The problem is he's only like 185, right? And he's nursing this wrist injury all offseason long without the ability to really bulk up and put on the strength the way some other running backs have.
More you can even put on that frame, to be honest.
I mean, he's got really long arms and broad shoulders. I think he could. He seems like the hardworking kind of dude that he could put some muscle on, but the wrist injury really holds him back. And he does run so hard that I don't know if he can hold up with that stature. He did last year, but he's kind of behind the eight ball. But then, I mean, you got this. I mentioned the offensive line improvements. You got Vic Fangio coming in there. They're going to have a great defense. They're going to be in games. Now, I do like Royce Freeman. Royce is a good player, and I think he can take some carries off of this guy. Yeah. And they did last year. They were splitting carries early, and then he picked up that high ankle sprain like in week 8 or 9, and then Phillip, you know, started to get more of the bulk of the carries. And I mean, but he just did so much.
He did
with
he did.
So little.
He did a lot with a little. He's the only rookie to go over 1,000 yards with, I think, under 200 carries or something along those lines.
Yeah, like 192.
Undrafted free agent or whatever. So here's what the problem is with all of these guys. Again, outside, you just said, I'll take Derek or I'll take Tyler Boyd, and Jay Wayne said, I don't want to be in this position because I don't want to take this guy. Outside of maybe Derrick Henry, who we just talked about, and Damian Williams, who we haven't even quite got to yet because it seems like everyone's a little scared of maybe just a 1 year, or even Carlos Hyde interfering with a little bit of...
Right.
I mean, we're in the minority there because everyone just thinks Carlos Hyde sucks.
Right.
But we'll get to that in a second. But all of these guys, Phillip Lindsay, you just said, really good player, does this or that. I mean, they just came in. The offensive coordinator right now who's going to run the system for... what the Broncos have going on is a Kyle Shanahan disciple. Like, in my opinion, this is about to be Devontae Freeman and Tevin Coleman. So I think you're about to just probably split a decent amount of Phillip Lindsay and Royce Freeman 50-50 is kind of what you were seeing in the beginning of last year till Royce got hurt. I think you're going to see more of it. So I think it caps both of their upsides.
But Phil has the game-breaking ability.
He does, but if I had to put them both in a box and pick one, I'm probably taking Royce Freeman. Like, I just like Royce Freeman. I think he's a really good player. I think he's probably a better pass catcher than Phillip Lindsay. I think he can run in between the tackles as well,
equal.
If not better. Phillip Lindsay had a really good year last year. I'm just saying, like, I think some
Lindsay
of that could
caught way more balls and had way more targets.
I mean, at last year because
yeah,
of
that's
what,
all we can go on.
Because
small sample size.
Because Royce got a high ankle sprain for half of the year.
He was still getting a decent amount of carries.
He still was, but I mean, he still was pretty injured and still playing. What's that tell you about the guy? So I think,
I like Royce Freeman.
I'm not
trying to take anything away from Royce.
What I'm getting at is I think you're going to have a balance, fight for a balance of power here. You mentioned Penny and Carson. Again, I think you're going to see a split there. Tough to call which one you're going to want each week. Sony Michel. Who the fuck knows if you want to play Sony Michel or not? Miles Sanders. Do I know if I want any part of Miles Sanders? At least he's young. So maybe I'm moving Miles Sanders above all these guys.
And he's got a second-round draft
pick. A fairly high draft pick. So all of these guys left. I think maybe if we're just talking about pure skills, I like Kenyon Drake better than all these guys at actual playing the position of running back.
Or Tevin Coleman so old.
Right. It's just like all these guys left here all have questions of who's going to be in the backfield with them and who's taking what from where. Like Cohen, maybe I want Cohen, but he's going to be fighting for scraps too. There's all sorts of players over there. You got Montgomery who can catch balls. Mike Davis could catch balls. Like all of a sudden, some of Cohen's upside is definitely taken away, and he's not going to be like, oh, we're going to put a bunch of balls in the gut of Cohen. So all of a sudden, all of these guys left outside of Damian Williams and potentially Derrick Henry are all in a clusterfuck of who's getting the ball.
Right.
I like it. You need to rewind that, listen to that. It was straight fire for a minute. So good. The rest of it, I forgot what I was almost forgot what I was going to say.
He'll think of something.
The Rashad Penny, Chris Carson thing, the duo there, though, versus the Phillip Lindsay, Royce Freeman duo, is I got an elite quarterback that's going to march me downfield and get me in the red zone.
That's fair.
At a much higher rate. Much higher rate than what Joe Flacco is probably going to do. Now, don't get me wrong.
Oh, Joe Flacco could be elite again this year.
Joe Flacco could do some all right things, but he did.
I was going to make this the YouTube video, but I don't know if I can put that out.
Most
there
likely,
anymore.
You don't. It's just we've seen it too many times. Quarterbacks changing teams, wide receivers changing teams. There's too much timing going on with a quarterback to change. He's not going to be elite.
I was at Casey's house. We were watching a little bit of training camp, and the Broncos quarterbacks were throwing balls, and they didn't have the names on the back of their shirts, and we weren't sure who was Locke and who was the other guy. But you knew who the fuck Joe Flacco was. He was walking around there like he had the biggest.
That ding dong was swinging.
Yeah.
So
anyway,
well, to be fair,
but Russell's is dragging the ground.
Sure.